Welcome back to my YouTube channel. For those who are new here, welcome. My name is Being Mona. I have my sisters here,
Kemunto
and
raising baby Ella in Africa.
Yeah. For today, we are talking about there's a subscriber who
requested video.
Yeah.
Yes.
To do this video, it's about
parenting.
Yeah.
Especially in African homes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Africans, by the way. Kenyans, to be specific. Yeah, so I'm going to talk about
the biggest mistakes, mostly the biggest mistakes parents do.
Yes.
Yeah, and the difference when we were younger and the now generation like us.
Oh.
How we take care of our kids.
Oh.
Yeah. And the biggest mistakes we do.
Yeah. In the things that you can do. You are not supposed to do even in front of your children or even the the kids that are you consider yours.
Mm-hmm.
Like the form of parenting also.
Yes, the form of parenting. Yeah, parenting is the toughest job you'll ever love in the world. But it gets crazy sometimes, but
see, and you should know, like, even when you give birth, even me, like me, with me being this big, okay? I'm still my parent child.
Okay.
Yes.
As in short, when you give birth to a child, know your responsibility till he dies.
In short, you will never get tired and you never get a leave while being a mother or guardian or whoever you
can I say
consider yourself to be.
Yes. And also we should start from the conception and the social perception of having a child in the African communities.
Yes.
I hate it when people mothers give birth for the name of people will see
what the society
say. So when you are giving birth to a child, don't give birth for your selfish reasons. Give birth because
you are ready
to be a mother, because being a mother is no joke. You are raising thieves, you are raising conmen, you are raising the presidents, and you are raising people in this world. So how you raise your children, it determines the citizens of the whole world.
The next generation.
So it's a very like God-given gift.
Don't
be careful.
And please, guys, the parents mostly, stop giving your child the center of attention.
Yes.
Yeah. Because out there, when he or she goes to school, he will demand that from other kids there. Now that you're in a leading it too.
Leading it to many dependents, being dependent on other people. So another thing about the raising children also is, always be, even if you're financially able, be in your child's life.
Yeah.
Especially when they are growing up, every step, every milestone of your child is really important. So it should be physically, emotionally, and physically, emotionally, and mentally available to rear these children, especially the ages of
teenagers.
The most difficult time to raise a child is during the birth, since like they're infants till like 5 years, and then when they are teenagers, and then when they are young adults, those are the stages that it can change their life forever.
But mostly this time, the SG, that you train a kid at the time out, the all in one time out. That if you do this and this, me Kitambo, I used to remember when my mother, when I do a mistake, she would tell me, if you do that again, we'll get punished for it. Set kunibembeleza, please talk. We talk.
Yes. Also comment down below your thoughts about caning your kids.
But coming to that, me, what I can say, you can't treat everybody,
every
kid the same, because we have also different behaviors also. Yes. Hi to them. You can't treat them equally. As in not, you can treat them equal, but you can't treat them the same, because like coming to in our family, we are 8 girls, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, we have different personalities, characters. So the way my mom could treat me is not the same that she could treat Ruth, because Ruth is different, I'm different. Yeah, in punishment, you can be punished, maybe the same punishment in the house. But in
I feel like caning a kid, me personally, I remember I was beaten only once with my father.
But then I remember when you do,
and my mother once.
Nakumbuka ile ni tukifanya mistake tunakuwa si wote, you are setting because you're the last born.
Yes.
So when you pray dad nani anaponea huruma na anatuacha all of us.
So you always made me cry so that if I can then. So me, the only time I was beaten it was once, evil. But the most me, I hate housework. So when I used to be like misbehave, they'll give me a house call. Because house call to Amy is not maybe difficult.
Yeah, it's not
so
difficult.
So when we get this thing the same, you won't see it as a me punishment.
Yeah, I hate me. Cooking.
Yeah.
So it's no, like we are different. Yes. It's a different part of personality.
Yeah, so like just know your child, train your child, they're individuals, and don't look at this household they are treating their child this way or that way. Another thing, don't give gifts in form of kufunika your emotionally unavailable as a parent to your child. I find mostly in rich family household, they usually
with the online thing. With the online now.
Yes, you'll find like they give the latest iPhone. So the child knows when like he or she wants a new iPhone, they'll start misbehaving, then the parent mistreat or whatever, and then they give they subscribe to it.
And then being afraid to let the kids get disappointment. Because at the end in life, when you grow up, they won't be there. You will not learn the consequences of life at all.
So that means like let the kids learn from their own mistakes.
Because they won't learn the skills.
Protect them every single time. They'll be codependent on you.
Okay, now let's talk another about the online things, the social media. Yeah, because there are many predators there. How will parents do about that? Will they track them or keep them?
I feel like we should always control the social media, because social media is the new, like I've seen like kids owning houses and things like that. So what I can say about social media, just be like controlling your, if they're underage, control your kids' social media.
And their apps.
Always always track their apps. I don't know how you can do it, but just be up to date with it. You are the parent. So always be like, don't cancel social media, but just make them like, if I, Kemunto, had a child, because I know how important social media is, if my child is interested with social media, I'll be up to date with his or her social media, and I'll limit them to only watching like, if it's weekends, only 4 hours of social media, 2 hours in the morning and 2 hours in the afternoon. Me, as a parent, I'll cancel TV on my child.
But when you are 18 years, you are free to do
if you are 18, you are free to do what you want. But ukumea pempe, go and look at your own roof.
Create your own rules.
Yes, I'll make you pay your own bills.
Okay, but coming to me kwangu, it will also depend on the upbringing of that child.
Yes.
How you brought that child from the ground. That's how you can even trust that child. And when you talk with her, or him, telling her, don't do this, I don't like you doing this and this, because trust that person, that child of yours from the way you brought that child up.
And that one will create more trust between the two of you. She or he will just be free with you.
You'll just trust her when you say that, don't do this and this, don't watch this site, don't watch this site. Because at the end of it, it will be also hard when you just tell that child, I don't want you to do this and this, and if you don't have the trust, and utamuamini ati, nikisema this, atafanya.
And you know kids nowadays, they know a way to go around about it. If you kikata hii, he or she will find another one.
You are saying about like where parents went wrong when raising us, Anna.
You can even say that it's a parenting.
I feel like I wasted a lot of time in school. It's my experience, you are not on my shoes. The only time I loved school is when I was in college. And the reason why I love school in college is because I focused on the units that I loved. Yes. I didn't have any. And one semester it was this unit, and we didn't have to cram this semester to the second semester. First semester would end, those units end there. We go to another semester. It's not about cramming. Eh? But the government, like our school system here in Kenya, the time I was in school, because Matiangi changed the school system. But when I was in school, I just used to hate and cramming things from form 1 to form 4. I remember I went even to my teacher and my chemistry teacher and told him, Aki, I want thing. Eh? I was good at other subjects, but chemistry is the only subject that made me to fail my exam. Yes. So I was like, what can I do? And my teacher told me, you will have to figure it out on your own. And he didn't care. So me, I feel if we could concentrate, school is good, but focus on, what talents we have. If it's football, you focus your child on football and to learn just basic things.
Like the CBC now.
Yes, just focus on that.
The disclaimer, that whatever we have said in this video, our personal experiences, we have seen it through our eyes, and it's happening in our day-to-day life. So